So at this time, I have one more update I'd like to, recognition of a student who impressed me so much. I was so proud to attend an event at Rutgers about 2 months ago on the Douglas campus. There was a professional development event for about 200 educators from around the state who wanted to learn more about global education, global awareness, and Highland Park High School was spotlighted. I mean, we were really out front as being a pioneer in the efforts to encourage global awareness through all the work we're doing. I have a lot of people to thank for that, including Mr. Gold, Mr. Lassiter. Mr. Lassiter was a forefather of sorts for this program, and Mr. Gold took it and ran. One student in particular really showed me something that I thought was worth sharing with the board, because some of the work that he did towards achieving his global citizenship seal speaks to some of the things that this board has discussed, including educational equity, the involvement of parents and whatnot. So I asked Farhan Rosati, if he would spend a few minutes talking about his work that I saw at Rutgers with the board, and here he is. So Farhan, why don't you come to the podium, and I'm gonna bring my computer to you so you can show a little bit of the video documentary you put together. So come on up, Farhan.
Hey guys, I'm Farhan Rosati. I am a senior at Highland Park High School. For my Global Citizenship project, I wanted to focus a bit on this thing that people always talk about called the Asian advantage. A little background, I came from Malaysia. I lived there for 9 years of my life, and it was the first 9 years, so I spent about 4 years in the Malaysian education system. When we came here, we always heard people talking about how Asians are inherently superior in academics, and my parents always talked about the Asian advantage. To understand more about this for my Global Citizenship project, I wanted to look at the actual truth behind it. I researched, and one of the aspects of my research was conducting interviews. And I interviewed 5 students. They were of Asian descent, and I interviewed them concerning their education here and what influenced their success. As a quick introduction, if you can see on the screen, there are 5 students, and I can't show you the whole video because it's too long, but I'll show you portions of it throughout. So, as I said before, here are the 5 students.
My name is Farhan Rosati, and I am a senior in Highland Park High School. This past year, I've been working on a project concerning the so-called Asian advantage. Typically, the Asian advantage is defined as a likeliness for Asian students to succeed in school and as a result, have a higher chance of success in life compared to other racial groups. At first, I thought the advantage came from a strict parenting style, which encourages students to strive for greater goals and as a result, gain academic and extracurricular excellence. However, as I conducted research and interviews, my hypothesis was disproved. In order to understand what I mean, I have to give more context. Therefore, here are the interviews I conducted on my mission to uncover the truth behind the Asian advantage.
My name is Jamie Achino.
Samita Shukla.
Jisoo Jung.
Tio Wang Lee.
Warren Yi.
And I'm going to Brown University.
Columbia University School of Engineering.
Princeton University.
New York University.
University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign.
As you can see, these 5 students that interviewed, you can say that they're highly successful because of where they're going to college. I selectively chose these 5 students because I felt that they represented the core of what people saw as the Asian advantage. But the one thing I learned from when I researched is that my initial hypothesis of these strict parents behind these students is what allowed them to succeed, because as we usually hear, Asian parents tend to be strict and tend to push their students to try and strive for greatness. But as I conducted these interviews, I realized that most, if not all of these students, their parents are less strict per se, but they're more encouraging and they act as a mediator to the students. An example would be, if you don't mind me using you, Amita. In the interview, in the video, she said that her parents did not try to push her to do more things. Instead, they kind of acted as a mediator in that they stopped her from doing too many things and spreading herself too thin. And since she did not try to do everything at once, she was able to succeed. And you can see that from her being able to attend Columbia University. So congratulations to her. I guess if there was one thing I learned from this project, even though I started out as trying to see it as a more cultural reason why these students succeed, it ended up being more of a familial reason, because these students, they had the correlation that they had was that their parents were behind them. They acted as a person or people to come to in case they need help. The parents were the sort of people that would encourage them to do other things or stop them from doing too many things. I also learned that it's difficult really to pinpoint exactly why these people succeed, because there are also a bunch of different subtopics that can affect their success, like socioeconomic class, like their familial environment, so on and so forth. Overall, this project really, really opened my eyes and helped me understand this sort of phenomenon that people talk about all the time. Helped me see that it's actually because of parents that allowed these students to succeed.
Does the board have any questions for Farhan? Well, Farhan, thank you for sharing. I appreciate that.
So Farhan is actually one of 17 students that achieved the Global Citizenship Seal this year. This was a brand new program that we've launched after 4 years of development with Rutgers, and specifically Mary Curran at the Rutgers GSE. And this year was the first year that we actually implemented the program and had seniors participate and complete their citizenship seal by finishing a senior project. So Farhan did a wonderful job in terms of investigating an issue that he was particularly interested in, and he's one example of many and all of the participants in the program that achieved the Global Citizenship Seal from Rutgers are actually going to be honored at graduation and recognized by the university. So the process that Farhan went through, he had to demonstrate that he had an ability to investigate the world and do research. He had to demonstrate an ability that he can think from multiple perspectives by not only interviewing 5 students, but also doing research as to what other people thought about the issue. Also, his ability to communicate effectively. He had to meet at Rutgers University multiple times and present in front of the community, and this is part of it. And then lastly, his ability to take action. So that was a production, the production of this video in which he's going to show you. So all of the students needed to complete those 4 tasks, and they all had a variety of different projects. Farhan was the only project that incorporated the board and a video, but all of them had to demonstrate these 4 skills and appreciation for global studies.